right. Looks like we have connected. Let me double check that it's running while I post to Discord. And share, publish, boom. Oh, and of course it kept the thumbnail, the full nude thumbnail. So weird how it does that. Okay, cool. Hey, welcome everybody. Well, let me tune it down a little bit. Welcome everybody. Adam Patrick Murray here with from PC World with Willis Lai on Zoom.
Hello, hello everyone.
This is not going to be an energetic stream. This is going to be a serious gameplay event. We are playing The Medium, which some have called the spiritual successor to Silent Hill. If you know me, you know Silent Hill is one of my favorite games of all time. So I have been chomping at the bit to play this game. Very excited. I was provided codes early, which is why I'm able to stream it today from NVIDIA, so thank you. And I am gaming on this reconfigured rig. Same internals, just I reconfigured it a little bit, but to recap, it's a Intel Core i9-9900KS with an EVGA RTX 3060 FTW3 Ultra Gaming GPU. I think I got the name right. Long name. With a Creative Sound Blaster AE9, and it is all running off a SK Hynix Gold P31 NVMe SSD, which happens to be the sponsor of today's stream. So I want to thank SK Hynix, who is the maker of fastest in class SSDs. For those of you who don't know, SK Hynix developed the world's first 128-layer NAND-based consumer SSD and is the world's second largest memory manufacturer. But what really sets them apart is incredible performance at affordable prices, surprising power efficiency, and 5-year warranties. In fact, SK Hynix makes the top picks for best all-around SSD and best NVMe SSD. Grab a Gold P31 or S31 on Amazon and give your PC a big upgrade. Thank you again to SK Hynix for sponsoring this, and let's jump straight into this, because Willis, I don't know if you know this, but I'm pretty excited.
I'm excited that you're excited about this.
Oh man, I am so excited. So yeah, I've launched the game to make sure that it runs and look at the configurations, which I'll go over here, but other than that, I haven't done much. So yeah, let's go over to the display. I'm running at 4K full screen, ray tracing to ultra, the quality custom. I'll show you that in a second. VSync is off, and I set the max frame per second to 60. As you can see, it actually defaulted to 30. From what I've heard, because this is an exclusive game on the Xbox platforms, that it actually is capped at 30 on consoles. But here on PC, we can go up to 60. I actually don't know if that's a hard cap, or if that's what. But yeah, we'll see. Anyway, I have everything maxed out, including DLSS set to high, and literally everything maxed out. I know that Digital Foundry did come out with a tech breakdown, but I think it was just for consoles. So I'm actually not quite sure on that end. On the PC side, hopefully they do some testing there. Anyway, I before we start, I do want to say I am a huge Silent Hill fan, and the thing that got me mostly excited about this game is that the soundtrack was co-composed by Akira Yamaoka, who was the composer on Silent Hill, and even directed at least one of them. So I'm probably not going to do a ton of talking in this because I just want to hear the damn music, to tell you the truth. But the game was developed by Bloober Team, which has done Layers of Fear, and I'm spacing on some of the other games they've done. Mostly a horror developer. I actually beat Layers of Fear recently. And I like him. I think this is from all the reviews I've read, should be pretty fun. I do want to say hi to everybody. Rick Elder, Triforce Gamer, what's going on? Gustavo, what's going on? Yeah, okay, then let's, Willis, are you ready? Are you locked and loaded?
Let's do this. I have my blankets just, you know, in case I need to cover up on any horror parts that's coming up.
Yeah, be sure to cover your eyes. All right, here we go. Let's hit new game. Oh, there's a little play button. I guess I hit play.
It all starts with a dead girl. Ever since I was little, I've had this dream. It's the end of summer. A girl is running through the woods. The moon, the scent of pines. And then the gunshot. It always felt so real. The blood on my cheek, the cold sweat running down my skin. I'd managed to convince myself it really happened. This scar of a memory. But part of me I could never fully understand. Well, that wasn't the only part. No wonder people used to think I was strange. If they only knew. That day when the phone rang, it was the hardest day of my life. The day I went home to say goodbye to my father. Dress him up for his last journey. Put him in a suit, fix his tie. Simple. Just the things he did every day. But looking through his stuff wasn't easy. I needed a moment to pull myself together. I was almost ready. I just had to find his special tie clip.
Adam?
Oh, sorry, I'm muted.
I think we lost your audio.
Oh, jeez, man. I muted myself because I took a drink and now I'm back. Anyway, sorry about that, everybody. Wow. I'm just so excited. So what I was saying was that I'm actually learning most of the story for the first time here because I have starved myself from information on all this because I just wanted to know fresh and, you know, not watch the trailers and the gameplay videos that were out there. So some of you in the chat might actually know more than me. I do want to go over the technical aspects real quick of the implementations of ray tracing. There's three of them. One of them is ray trace reflections. So reflective surfaces have real-time ray tracing implementation. Ray traced transparent reflections, meaning that transparent objects like windows are also going to have ray trace reflections. And then ambient occlusion, which is kind of I don't fully know a good way to describe it other than it's almost kind of like a shadow. It's something to kind of ground the object in the space and provide a little bit of shadow around the edges so that it looks cohesive. It's kind of hard to describe. I'm not a technical person, so. But anyway, with that, I do have everything maxed out, even with DLSS set to the highest setting. So I've also been told by NVIDIA that the naming on this will change day of. I have a pre-release review copy. I think they're going to change the verbiage to performance, balanced, and quality. I have it on high, which is the quality setting right now. If it loses any sort of frame rate, I'll probably bump it down to balanced. So anyway. Let's dig into it. Oh, 1999. Right before Y2K. I will say too that this game features static camera angles. They said that was the best way to kind of portray the world. They've mostly done first person games, so third person is a little new to them. Oh. So it kind of harkens back. Oh, kitty!
Shit!
Oh,
yeah. Nice to see you too.
I think the kitty was meant to scare you, but it actually just got me like excited. Like, hey, kitty! I'm already happy. There's a cat in the game. Oh,
Jack's room.
Hi, kitty.
It's like he never. Damn it!
Oh, that's a pretty kitty. Oh, where's the pet button? Damn it! There's no pet button.
That's already a no-no for Adam.
Now I'm
pissed. Jack was a humble, religious man. He ran a funeral home, and I'd help out whenever I could. It felt good to be useful.
So it does have these first-person little vignettes when you, like, click on something, so it's
I used to think I'd never fit in. But Jack, he didn't mind my weirdness. He kept telling me I was special. Keep hissing at me. Who do you think's gonna feed you now?
Oh, kitty, don't be hissing. Come on. Rakesh, no, this is not a Founders Edition 3080. It's a EVGA RTX FTW3 Ultra Gaming GPU.
Come on, Jack. Where'd you put it? Okay. Let's do this the other way. There you are. Jack was part of the Solidarity movement. He spent a few months in an internment camp, but even that couldn't dampen his spirit.
So I'm getting a bit of screen tearing and it's bugging the hell out of me, so I am going to turn on VSync.
Weird to be back in my old room. So many memories. My oldest family heirloom. As a kid, I'd show this to people just to freak them out. I'd usually say something like, pretty sick, huh?
It's an ICU admission card.
Oh.
Initial diagnosis, a three-year-old, this is when she was 3 years old. Second degree thermal burns covering 35% of total body surface area, trunk and upper limbs. Suspected inhalation injury. Oh boy.
I used to get a lot of these. To me, they were like trophies. Badges of honor for doing the right thing. Jack wasn't too amused, but he did his best to cover for me. I kind of feel bad for making him go through all that.
Oh yeah, so she's a medium. Duh, that's, yeah. The name of the game.
Kids from the orphanage. Not all of them had my luck. That's why I kept coming back. To play. To take care of them. To listen. That was the least I could do. Spirits. There was a time I'd try to run from them. To ignore their calls. Matthew was the first one I helped pass on. Yeah. I used to have a thing for them. Don't know why, really. I guess they just used to make me happy. Jack knew it well. That's why there's so many of them here.
Real quick, the Twilight Star, this is a 4K monitor. That's 60 hertz, so. Yeah, this, sorry. I am gaming at 4K, but I'm streaming at 1440p. Sorry, I should have clarified that. But yeah, I am definitely not getting a solid 60 here. Let me try to turn the DLSS to what is going to be named the balanced mode. To see what kind of jump up that gets. Oh, the kitty bowl. Feed the kitty. Oh, yes, you can. Oh no, I don't have it on me.
You have no food.
Oh no.
Looks.
There it is.
Nourishing.
So I'd like to point out here, if I left an open can of cat food on my counter, it would be on the floor and completely, and BB would just be like laying by it, just like kind of like moving it into her mouth like this.
Well, you let your guard down.
Yeah.
You didn't clean up your mess.
And this is not in English. I'm pretty sure they said this was set in Poland. Sears of Mine in Trezbenia City.
Trezbenia.
All right, let's feed this kitty. This kitty's hungry.
Here you go. What's your face?
Oh.
Glad to see you're still kicking around.
Yeah, I just got an achievement to feed the cat. I wish I got an achievement every time I fed BB.
BB knows. You know, the achievement pops for that.
I can't believe it's all still here. Oh, Jack.
Oh, I can develop my own photos. Huh.
I guess I forgot about this one. I can do it now.
Oh. Sweet. Alright, so what was the instructions? Illuminate the photo for 5 seconds. I'm gonna assume this is what the illumination thing is. I've never actually, even though I'm a photographer, I've never shot film, so. Other than Polaroid, which I guess is kind of film. But, instant film. 1001, 1002, 1003, 1004, 1005. Okay. Illuminated paper. I got it. Now dip it for 3 seconds. Dip it in multigrade for 3 seconds. Oh no, that's... Oh, this is multigrade. Okay, so we're going right to left. Here we go. 1001, 1002, 1003. Okay. Dip in stop for 3 seconds. I'm gonna assume this is stop. The bottle is not marked. 1001, 1002, 1003. Okay. I wonder if this is actually how it's would work. Have you ever done film?
I was going to ask you the same thing. Have you done film, developed film before? I have.
Never. All right, so 3 seconds in Fixer. 1001, 1002, 1003.
That was the last photo I took of you, Jack. Shit.
Okay, well, there we go. We made photos.
Yay.
There's more paper. So I want to make more.
If you want to learn, you get this game.
I know, right?
This part. Yeah, I've always wanted to learn it. It's interesting technique.
Before the pandemic, I actually I don't know if you know of that photo place in Berkeley, Looking Glass, I think it's called.
Yes.
Yeah, I wanted to take classes there. They do classes, but then the pandemic hit. So.
Yeah. I've rented lenses there before, and they have occasional classes. I just didn't have the opportunity to go.
Interesting.
1984, light reading. At least he keeps the toilet seat down. Do not want to see what's in his toilet. Yeah. I wish we had a washer and dryer, or at least a washer. Jeez, that'd be nice.
Hard to find in-unit.
We lived upstairs from Jack's funeral home. It wasn't as weird as it sounds. Besides, if it wasn't for that, I may never have learned to use my powers.
Gotta say, that's some good sounding rain. Oh, Rick Elder says they got it wrong. There should be a rinse bath after the fix, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, the cat food named is cat treats in Poland, or Polish. That's cool. That's awesome. Thank you. Huh.
So this is set in Poland?
I'm pretty sure I read that.
Jack,
yeah.
Taught me to accept my condition. Of all my foster parents, he was the only one who saw it as a gift and not a curse.
Weird, my controller's rumbling when I get close to that car for some reason.
Spooky.
Jack's in the prep room.
That says prep room. I'm gonna explore a little bit before I go in the prep room. See if I can go check something else out.
So Rick Elder says the developers simplified the developing process for the game. For color printing, the process is more complex, and they just set that room up to a simplified black and white room.
Rather.
Good to know.
That's cool. Yeah, I'm sure that's not the actual process.
I was like, that's pretty quick.
I mean, if that was real, yeah, that'd be pretty easy. Oh no, name of deceased Adam?
Oh no.
Oh, nope, not me. I wasn't born in 76. Thank goodness. Birthplace Krakow.
Sure.
I don't know. Date of death, 1999. I don't think I died right before the Y2K. Oh, well, this is kind of grim. I guess if you've had to deal with a death, you've had to do this of be like, okay, well, what kind of services do you want to pay for? They paid to dress the body, but not to put makeup on the body or do their hair. Yeah.
Here it is.
Oh, I guess I couldn't have gone in the prep room anyway, because there's the key.
Real quick, $5 super chat from South Memphis. Thank you so much.
Hey, thank you. You are awesome. Much appreciated. Yeah. Haven't got scared yet though. If Willis jumps out of his seat, I'll give a $5 super chat.
I have you to blame. You buy pizza.
Exactly. Oh, for a second there, I thought I heard somebody in the game typing, and then I realized it was you typing on your keyboard.
Oh, sorry, it was me.
No, I was just like, wait, is somebody else in the other room typing? Is Jack here? I thought he was dead. Speaking of mortuaries, did you ever watch, what was that show, 6 Feet Under?
6 Feet Under? No. Which
that TV
that
show?
One?
Yeah, it was an HBO TV show called 6 Feet Under. Really good show. Really good show. Highly recommend. I don't know if it holds up today, actually, but at the time I watched it and it was really good.
Not sure if I'm ready for this. Jack.
Hmm. I think she said it was her brother, right?
So, she's very casual about it. Just like, hey, Jack, there you are.
I mean, if she's a medium, I'm sure she's dealt with a lot of this.
Got your special clip?
No. Oh.
Where's your tie?
I was about to say, I was like, I can't put the... Oh, there it is. I gotta say, that's a pretty cool tie. Nice little clip.
Yeah.
He's rocking it.
Snazzy. Wouldn't have Snazzy, it any other babe. Way.
So, Rook... Oh. Stupid thing. From this angle, at first I was like, "Oh, with the bald head, he looks like Agent 47 from Hitman." But different game.
It's just bald.
Yeah, it's just a bald man.
Yeah.
Sorry, what were we gonna say?
Steve Cook said Jack is the foster parent.
Oh, okay. Thank you. I guess I wasn't paying attention.
Extreme Meg 80 says it's Jeff Bezos.
I think he would have a nicer tie. Nothing wrong with Jack's tie, but yeah.
I didn't expect this to be easy. I guess I didn't know what to expect. When things get personal, it just burns you from the inside out. I guess you're ready. But am I? People read the signs, it's closed.
Oh, I see Eskimo Monsters here. What's going on? I gotta say, this is the music so far. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Very subtle, very chill, very atmospheric. If there's one thing I did read in all the reviews, even the ones that didn't necessarily like the game as much, they did say it's dripping with atmosphere. So, yeah.
What the hell?
Ah.
Guess you felt it.
That's
too.
A cat? Oh, that's the cat.
No.
And then it happened. As it did so many times before. Just when I thought my day couldn't get any worse.
Oh. Where is that darn notebook? I'm gonna be late. I need to find that. Marianne? Marianne, are you crying, my child?
I Jack.
Now, you didn't happen to see my notebook, did you, darling? My memory's a bit fuzzy. So much for aging gracefully.
Where is that? Listen, Jack. You should probably get some rest. Forget the notebook.
Oh, no, no. I've got so much work, my dear.
It's okay, Jack.
I can't just...
What? Let it go. It's not important.
You are crying. What's wrong, dear? Why is it so cold in here? Where is that?
It's okay, Jack. It's okay.
My sweet little Marianne. What would I ever do without you?
Jack. Don't worry about it. It's time to get some rest.
Oh, Marianne.
Yeah?
Oh, I'm worried about the surgery. When I'm at the hospital, are you sure you're going to be all right?
Yes, Jack. It's going to be fine.
You know, I promised myself once I would never let anything happen to you. Not while I'm around.
I'll be fine. I promise.
No risky stuff, then. Huh? Right?
All right, Jack. Now, get some rest.
I need... Oh, yes. Be good, Marianne. I love you, my child. I've loved you since the moment you walked into my life. Remember that.
Most people would give anything to have that opportunity. To say all the things that were left unsaid. But it didn't make things any easier. I could help 1,000 souls cross over, but when it came to Jack, it still hurt like hell.
I love you too, Daddy.
I used to think everyone saw the world the way I did. Divided. Torn between two realities. But no. I was the only one. Or so I thought.
We're closed. There's another funeral home across town. I can give you the number.
Marianne.
Who is this?
You don't know me, Marianne. But I know you.
Look, if this is a joke...
You'd need to listen to me, Marianne.
Okay, I'm hanging up.
I know what you are.
What? Who is this?
My name is Thomas. I need your help.
Listen, if that's all you've got, I'm...
No, there's more. I can give you the answers you've been looking for your whole life. But I need you to trust me.
Trust you? I don't even know you.
It all starts with a dead girl.
What did you say?
The Nemo Resort. Find me there. Please. The light, it's almost gone. It's not dark yet, but it's getting there. You're the only one who can stop it. You're my only chance.
Hello? Hello? Shit.
Hmm. So far, I'm digging it.
Hey.
What do you think so far, Willis?
So far, I have not, you know, crept into my blankets yet. But yeah, no, so it's good. It's interesting, that last sequence right there. That she's in the medium, I guess.
Is
that
she is a medium, and she can cross over, or she can see dual realities, like the you know, where the people are. Like, yeah, it was interesting. It was happening in the real world. It's not like she transported somewhere. It was happening where it was, but she saw it differently at the same time as well. Interesting. Sam, what's going on? Can you check the game on interactivity with the environment? I'm not quite sure what you mean by that. If you can expand on that for me. Oh, Rick said earlier it looks like Ben Kingsley.
Yeah. Found footage is,
yeah, right. I like this that style too. That was like the dual realities. I've known that was a thing. And I do know that most of the game happens at this Niwa resort. That kind of intro sequence was
And off I went, different. On nothing but a hunch. A call from a complete stranger. But I'd learned to trust my instincts, and there was something about this guy, his voice. Felt like I should know him. Either way, he sure seemed to know me.
Elena lurking in the chat with the sound off.
The sound's the best part. If you're not going to watch it, you have to listen to it. That's like the best part. To tell you the truth, I've been listening to the Silent Hill soundtrack a lot recently, getting myself excited for this. So, and I'm very excited for this soundtrack to... They've released a couple songs, but with it coming out tomorrow, hopefully the whole soundtrack will be available. I mean, even if this game blew chunks, the game itself, but the soundtrack was awesome, I would totally beat the shit out of it.
Right off the bat, I could feel there was something off about that place.
Orodek W. Pazzi. Nice motorcycle. The audio is hitching a little bit. I'm not
home?
Quite sure what's going on.
I guess not.
I don't know if other people are hearing that as well, but...
Eski Monster says, perfect soundtrack for sleep. I'm like, I don't know if I can fall asleep to the soundtrack, you know, especially it's a bit ominous and eerie for some tracks.
I actually do listen to Silent Hill soundtracks sometimes before I go to bed. there are certain songs that are not okay to sleep to, but most of the music is ambient enough.
You want to keep me out, Neva?
Oh, I guess I'm just breaking in. I will say this is not the final version of the game, though I am running on the newest game ready drivers, so this performance is a little bit lacking. It's I'm surprised once again. It's targeting 4K 30 for the consoles.
Not a whole lot of people knew about Neva. It used to be a government-owned vacation resort until one day it just stopped. And so an urban legend was born. The Neva Massacre. The details were always fuzzy, crazed workers, ancient curses. You know, the usual.
So we got, sorry if I butcher the name, Wotech Pod and Boria Zero both said it's the name of that place is the Holiday Resort. It says Holiday Resort.
Oh, hey, man, thank you. That's so awesome that you know Polish.
Thank you.
Holiday Resort, that's cool. Dang, that's, yeah, that's awesome. Thank you for helping us translate that. I feel lucky to have you in the chat to help me.
We got two people who know Polish in the chat, which is awesome.
That's awesome. Whoa, man. That's super cool. Yeah, thank you. was that a croquet ball? Or a, you know?
Croquet ball?
Hello.
Oh.
Okay, so yeah, I knew this. The left bumper turns on, like, her insight, which I think is kind of her way to view the other world or something. Not quite sure, but... Oh, yeah. Huh. Well, I think those footsteps are going somewhere. Can't click on anything. I guess I can't follow the footsteps. Oh man, this is really pretty. This is really detailed. Oh, the music just makes so I literally could just sit here and just listen to the music for a while.
You'll just have a chair and then a vinyl recorder. Just sit right there in that forest area and just listen to the music.
Yeah.
So you can have the whole ambience.
I totally would. Oh man, I hope this soundtrack comes out on vinyl. Damn.
What's
it.
This?
You made me think. Oh, I am following the footprints, okay. T plus K, 1958? No, 68. Also reminds me a little bit of Metal Gear Solid 3. I feel like I should just crouch down and change to a different camo.
Yeah.
Out in the middle of the wilderness.
Oh my goodness. It's been a while since I played that game. And Skill Monster says there's a lack of spiders in my opinion.
You know what? That's okay. Who knows, maybe there aren't spiders in Poland. I don't know, I've never been there.
Huh. Looks like an old fort. Might be my way in.
Dude, if I came across something like this in the middle of the woods, hell yeah, I would explore it. Oh, it's... yeah.
Rick Elder in the beginning of the stream says that this game is going to be available on Game Pass, I believe.
Yeah, it's exclusive to Microsoft platforms, and yeah, it's releasing day and date on Game Pass. So if you have Game Pass, do it. I had pre-ordered it on Steam, actually, but then I got the review code. But I also have Game Pass, so yeah. I believe it is full retail price. I think it's $50 if you don't have Game Pass.
I see. Yeah,
Unearthed.
I might just play it on. I might just play it on Game Pass myself. I got Game Pass recently as well.
Wait, hold on. You would play a horror game on your own accord?
For your sake. Just to, yeah, because yeah. you're convincing me how awesome the music is. And then, you know. Well, if it gets to the even stranger and scarier parts, I'm just going to call you on Zoom. It's like, okay, Adam, you're going to play with me right here.
I'll say one of the cool things about this that I do know is that there is no combat in this. So this is more of like your experience in the game. You're either solving puzzles or interacting with things. I believe you are escaping from something as well, but there's no combat, which is nice. Which some horror fans like it, some horror fans don't. It always depends, because Bloober Team usually doesn't put combat in their games. Like Layers of Fear, there's no combat in it. You're just kind of like experiencing it. But some people think it's really minimal, and it's like, well, is it even a video game? But yeah, it's, you know, different strokes for different folks. But I think this is probably a pretty good one to start off on.
The split would come and go. If a place had a story to tell, well, I guess I was there to listen.
So she called it the split. That's the interesting. Split. So it's weird. I can't necessarily tell. Is she seeing both things at the same time? Or is she in the other one where we're... But it's just showing us both? Curious. I mean, it is pretty crazy that to make every single one twice and, you know, kind of replicate everything. Hmm. And you're actually playing it it's rendering two different versions of the game. I mean, I'm not a developer, but this seems pretty cool.
Yeah, that's interesting.
Oh, and look at this. So look, there's the button prompt is different for the real world and the split world. I don't know what that means. Let's see.
Dead. Like everything else in this place.
Oh, look at that. And if you look at the bottom, A, focus on spirit world. Hmm. Oh, interesting.
Yeah.
Wait, so the spirit world door is open, but in the real world... Oh, the material world is what they're calling it. Okay. Oh, it looks like the line leads to a panel somewhere. Wait, so what happens if I hit forward? Do I just stop? Oh,
you both stop.
Okay. Yeah. So I even though the door open technically is open on the spirit world, I can't. Wait, so...
Yeah, not getting through here. Not with the power out. When you exist in two realities, you're affected by either. I'd learned that the hard way.
I would assume you would follow that line, but I can't follow that line out. There's nothing to interact on. Yeah, the line just goes out. Huh, okay.
See if you can find an axe or a lockpick in the real world.
In the lockpick, yeah. Oh, there we go. There's something.
Old and soaked in misery. Figures, I guess. 1,000 years of history doesn't just happen. It's paid for. But even in the deepest darkness, light can linger. Lonely. Fragile. Waiting for someone to embrace it.
So, in the spirit world, that's a really cool effect. Those all look like people. Looks like a crowd going into the back. Like, it gives it that depth. That's pretty awesome.
As I absorbed the energy, I wondered who it was that left it behind. A dying soldier whispering the name of his beloved? Or maybe just glad to be done with this world?
I'm gonna assume I absorbed enough. It looks like her jacket lit up more now that I absorbed that stuff.
That's a pretty cool jacket.
In any case, I figured I could use it. Energy's energy, right?
Oh, so that worked. Good for you, Marianne.
These powers of mine, as much of a pain in the ass as they were, they did come in handy sometimes.
Oh, so I overrid it in the spirit world, so in the real world it should be open now. Overrode it, I'm sorry. Is that the right word? I'd probably say that.
So there I was, existing in two worlds, but never really living in either.
I gotta say, I kinda like these fixed camera angles. I mean, even though it would be nice to be able to move around in a 3D space, like, it does feel a lot more directed and scripted. I mean, once again, I'm not a developer, obviously, but I think that probably helps development as well, to be able to know exactly what somebody can look at any given point. Yeah, this is a thick-ass forest.
Just some gamer is asking, is this with DLSS on? I think you have that on balance, right?
Yes. Yeah, I started off 4K, pretty much everything on, set to ultra, and then, oh, oops, no, I had to go down to advanced. Yes, DLSS is on, right now it's called low, medium, high, but the actual release of the game will be performance, balanced, quality. So I had it on balanced, but now I'll click back to quality, just see how it is. I'm going to keep VSync on, though, because there's definitely screen tearing.
Oh, what happened to you?
That's a good question. Oh, look, there's those little steps again. Oh, a little overhead. Oh, I love the look at this forest. It just makes me want to go take a hike.
Take a hike, Adam.
Yeah, go take a hike, will ya? Why, I oughta. Looked like a
the
big
aura
gate.
In that place. I've seen others like it, but never this intense. It was like a landfill of memories, emotions, and none of them good.
So, because it's one of my favorite movies of all time, we actually rewatched. It's not that weird. We watched The Shining a lot, and it's funny because The Shining. This is giving me Shining vibes. where the place has a lot of stuff that has gone on there that, like, holds energy. And the place is almost like a character in itself. Also, it sounded like she pronounced it Niva, like N-I-V-A, instead of Niwa. Maybe our Polish people can help us understand that.
Hey, phone.
Should I answer? What do you think, Willis?
Answer it.
All right, let's see.
Find the echo?
Oh, there's like a little tear.
I'm here. No, there's definitely something. Trust me, you made the right call sending me. Yes. It's only a matter of time. I'm here. No, you trust me. Yeah.
Even the objects here had auras. When I touched them, I could sense their stories. Words, images, feelings left behind.
That is a pretty cool looking payphone. I think another reason why I like these fixed camera angles is because it kind of looks cinematic. And maybe, like, it's just like, I'm thinking, like, man, how would I shoot this? You know, it's kind of cool to, like, see the camera move. And some of it is very, like, cinematic. Some of it is video gamey, but I don't know. I kind of dig it. Alright, so I'm going to do a real quick test, just because I'm curious. So right now, walking around this little area is definitely tanking the frame rate. So it's about 26, 27 as I loop around here. Let me go back to DLSS balanced. And now just kind of do a couple loops. I just want to see the frame rate difference. Okay, so it's about 5 frame difference. Once again, this game was definitely made for consoles and they were targeting 30 FPS, so I imagine if I went in here and did the max FPS to 30, which it actually defaulted to, that's probably what they were, like, intending people to do. Which, to tell you the truth, this is probably how I would play it. Or how I will play it later, because it's definitely a lot less frame hitching in this. And I mean, it's not an action game. I'm not a hard stickler for. Don't tell Gordon. I'm not a hard stickler for 60. A game like this, I could totally be fine with capping it on 30 and just, like, maxing everything out. But I'm not gonna do that here.
Hello? Anybody in there?
Locked. Obviously. There's gotta be another way.
Ooh. Frame rate definitely tanked in that scene. Oh. What's that up there?
Ah. I think there's a broken window up there. If only I could reach it.
Jump.
It's just like crash in. Okay. Yeah, so in the chat we have Wotek Pod and
Well, I've already
Zero
proven
both
my prowess as a dumpster climber.
That both the W is similar to V in English.
Oh.
In Polish, yeah. Polish W is similar to V in English.
Also, I will point out right here that we are dropping to...
Ooh.
This is bad. this is not good. I'm like 10 frames, 8 frames a second. This is not okay.
What happened here?
I don't know. Handle's missing.
Maybe I could replace it with something.
Once again, I am running the pre-release version of the game, so hopefully some of this will iron out. I'm not sure. I guess I got to try to look for a handle. Oh, well, maybe I should follow this arrow on the ground. The bosom of nature.
The bosom of nature.
Interesting. Oh, there's another one of those little drawings. Timer.
Now, what's a fine machine like you doing in a place like this?
It's a pretty cool car.
Doubling as a spare bedroom, apparently.
Oh, man, this shot right here just reminds me of the beginning of Silent Hill 2 when he reaches in his car to get the map. Hey, that looks fun. Go to the Neva Resort. F. Signed F.
F.
To Josephine Wozniak? What? Hold up. The Wozniaks? Just kidding.
Hope you don't mind if I pop your trunk.
Wait. She called the trunk? No, that's the hood of the car. Okay. Oh, nope. Actually, that's here. I guess that's the trunk. Oh.
Although, this could come in handy.
Yeah, screwdriver. I'll take it.
Ow! Shit!
Oh, okay.
What the hell?
What the hell?
I wouldn't say that startled me. It just caught me by surprise. Yeah, I've yet to watch the Digital Foundry video, so that's, I'll be curious to see how it is. Alright, let's see if I... Oh boy, wow,
oh,
this is...
still the same.
Oh
still
my goodness, same. Oh, this is bad.
It's just one part.
Alright, let's get through this part. Yikes.
So began the great dumpster heist of 1999.
I love areas like this where it's like the outside has, you know, the outside world has started to like reclaim the inside. That's why I love like seeing like broken down places
I'm
and just seeing the wild
tired of
retaking.
Your shit, Neva. You better be worth it.
Don't cut yourself. I know, right?
Oh my goodness.
there's one of those things on this shoe. Where is it? Oh, there it is. Well, I guess a lot of bad things happened with this shoe.
Oh, boy.
So it's
true. It's so clean, though. It looks clean.
The Neva Massacre. I need to find this Thomas guy and get the hell out of here.
I wonder if that's a real shoe brand. It looks like it says L-U-K-S-U-S-Y. Luxusi? Luxusi? That's a cool thing on the art. Okay. Hopefully we're still holding. I just got a little notification from YouTube, a little error. If you guys can in the chat can confirm the stream is still up.
I see it. It's still okay. Up. Right now.
See what difference to FPS changing the RTX setting, please.
Sure.
Oh, you know what? Let's do it in a place where it's like really chugging, and then I think that'll be a little bit better. Luxury's Luxusi.
No.
I guess it's
Google
a real
that.
Thing.
Is it real?
I don't know. He's making it sound like it's real.
Hello? Anyone? Thomas? You there?
The duckling?
Polish legends, the dragon of Walwell Hill. Why do my teeth... Why do my teeth fall out? Page 7. Back to school, page 9. Puzzles and crosswords, page 10, and much more.
I was going to say, don't forget the W is a V.
Oh, yeah.
So it's what? It's V?
Wawel Hill?
Wawel Hill?
Little Red Riding Hood's theater cutout. Oh, that's kind of cute. Is there anything on this one? No, I guess not. Ah, good old map. Oh, wait, I can't take the map.
You just have to screenshot it.
Yeah, right? You are here. There I am. I don't know where I'm supposed to go then. This room has an E on it. And that other one over there by the four does too. Ooh, I'm going to hit the bell.
Hit the bell.
Oh, I can't hit the bell.
And welcome Matthew Lane.
Hey, Matthew Lane. Happy birthday. You know, the birthday is the best time to get scared in a video game. by the way, sinners be damned. Wait,
sinners be damned.
I am cat and I licking my balls.
What?
just reading the game. There's a couple other words in there. Okay.
So immature, Adam.
Yeah, man. Oh, also vote for Pedro. Nice. Glad to know in 1990. Wait. When did Napoleon Dynamite come out? Was that... I think it was before 1999. Oh. Look at these names. Brunin, Halinia, Halina, Victoria, and Boris. Okay. Where is Mike Eslin? Oh, you know what? Let me... No, okay. Wait. No, nothing. Little ballerina. The star of the Bolshe Theater. Vivian. Excuse me. Quality time by the lake. Thank you. see, that looks nice. I'd go there, let's say. Oh, this is all by the same person, F. Yeah, it totally is. Huh, okay. I wonder who this F character is. You know what? Maybe this is a good spot to look at the RTX settings. Say I'm getting about 42 frames a second here in this little area. 41 is the lowest dip I've seen, up to 44. Okay, let's try. I don't have offhand what the different levels of ray tracing quality is. Let's see. Oh no, I need to go back. Because there's ultra, which I have, and then on, then off. I believe ultra. All right, give me a second. I can find it. I actually have it in a PDF. This is according to the RTX reviewer guide provided by NVIDIA. It says, let's see. Okay, here we go. So on is RT ambient occlusion and reflections. Oh, but the ambient occlusion is only for single reality, and the reflections are only enabled in select locations for single reality. You crank it up to ultra, then it's ambient occlusion, reflections, transparent reflections, and reflection enhancements. And it's enabled for both single and dual realities on all of them. Okay, so it's definitely, yeah. All right, let me list this off. Sorry, for a second. RT on, which is this one. RT only in one world game mode. RT disabled in dual reality mode. So it's only when you can see one world. RT AO is used all the time. RT reflections are used in specific locations. RT Ultra, which is what I had it on, is RT is used in both in one world and dual reality game modes. RT AO is used all the time. RT reflections are almost always used. It says some outdoor locations with heavy foliage are excluded. Hybrid translucency is enabled, and some additional effects are enabled for RT reflections. Okay, so that's so it looks like Ultra is definitely a resource. Okay, so let's go back to on. Okay, yeah, so now I'm able to hit a solid 60. Let's take off VSync. Let's just see where it's going to. Oh, you know what? Yeah, this game must be capped at 60 by the developer, so. Okay, I'm just going to leave VSync on then. But personally, I want RTX set to ultra, so that's I'm going to stick to it, even though we're getting a performance penalty here. Like I said, when I play this on my own, I'm probably going to play it and cap it at 30.
Hello? Thomas? Easy, Marianne. It's just a good old-fashioned haunted hotel. Calm yeah. your ass down good and answer the bell.
Hotel. Ooh, and the lights are shining. Exactly. Exactly. Feeling something bad's gonna happen.
there.
Oh, hi. You startled me.
I did, didn't I? You look real scared. I'm Sadness.
Marianne. Sadness. Is that your name? I mean, you seem pretty cheerful to me.
Well, it's what I remember. My friends used to call me by a different name. But I don't remember what it was.
Your friends?
Oh, yeah. I used to have a lot of friends here. But they're all gone now.
Did something happen to them?
I don't really want to talk about it.
That's okay. So, do you live here? All by yourself?
You wouldn't believe how boring it gets sometimes.
I can imagine. This place must have been...
Oh, yes. So busy. People coming and going all the time. Always someone to play with.
Must have been nice.
It was. Not anymore.
So, tell me, what happened?
I remember. People stopped coming. Only a few of them stayed. But they became very sad. Very angry. They might hurt you.
Thanks. But I can take care of myself. Hey, I was wondering, have you seen...
Marianne?
Yes?
Would you play with me? Just for a little while. It's been so long since I played with anyone.
Oh, okay. But I need your help first.
Yes. Yes!
I'm looking for a man. Thomas. Do you know him?
Let me think. I've heard that name before. Somewhere.
Take your time.
Oh, yeah. The second floor. We can look there. Come on. Hurry,
oh, wait. I can't go that way. Somehow.
Seen some really weird pop in. It's in both realities. Yikes. So I believe it just saved. I'm actually going to pop out to the menu, try to reload real quick. I'm gonna take this opportunity to thank our sponsor, SK Hynix, for sponsoring this game. Don't worry, I'll be right back with the game. I just want to relaunch it. Thank you, SK Hynix. I have a SK Hynix Gold P31 in this rig right now. That is what the game files and the OS are installed on. Let's get back in here. I just wanted to reload a little, real quick, just to see if that helped with that pop in or not.
That music was pretty good.
Right?
The last music we heard, I was like, woo.
Yeah.
Nice.
Especially with a little brum brum, which it reminded me of one of a soundtrack from a Miyazaki movie. I couldn't tell
Miyazaki
which.
Movie?
Yeah, something. I don't know.
I'm still seeing it on you.
Yeah, I'm still seeing that pop in. The textures took a second to pop in. It looks like it's not flashing anymore, so that's good. Okay, well. Okay, now let's keep going. Hey. Oh yeah, take the elevator.
An elevator. Might as well see if it works.
Hey, you know what? What can go wrong? Oh, you know what? I want to look at the sign. I love these old signs. The Neva restaurant, the people's taste. Come hang out in the day room, the safest place for the youngest.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I feel like you don't necessarily have to say that unless
you do.
Right?
Right.
Oh, you know what I just realized? So yeah, it's once again, pre-release version of the game. It every time I reset it's clicking back down to 30 frames a second, which is weird. Look in the DLSS quality, reset to medium.
So none of those settings are saved when you quit back out.
It doesn't seem like it. Doesn't seem like it. Once again, I don't know if that's for the final version of the game, but I'm at least seeing it here.
We got Mark Van Velsing Sadness. Photography in the chat says thank you Adam for the stream. Happy to check. Happy with it, so I can check how it looks. How does the control feel for you? Is it intuitive?
Okay, Marianne. Oh, just take a deep breath.
Yeah, the controls feel fine to me. It's pretty simplistic. Yeah, I'm using controller the Xbox Elite Series 2 controller. Getting some nice vibration feedback. It's not a problem. Press and this is a new one. Press and hold B for an out of body experience.
Let go.
Okay. So now I can. I'm just in this one world.
There, a fuse box. Need some energy to spark it up.
So that's interesting. You can leave your body behind. Oh, gotta move fast. Oh, there it is down there.
An out-of-body experience. It's like taking a plunge into nothingness. Stay under for too long and it just pulls you in.
Oh boy, frame rate's tanking here.
Oh, wow. Whoa.
Yikes. This is not cool. Oh, wow. 5 frames a second here. I wonder if it's because of the effects that are happening on her body? Weird. That is not good.
Okay, Marianne.
Oh, and now it's...
Now get your ghostly ass back and power up that elevator.
And now it's okay.
Okay.
Okay, so now I'm going to go back out of body again. Stay close to the generator, hold RT.
Uh-huh.
Hey, there we go. Yeah, that did it. Man, wow, I really hope performance improves on this. That is not okay. Yikes. Oh, it looks like another little block. I wonder if... Oh, actually, no, it's blocked in both areas. I can't go either way. Ooh, I really like this poster. The art... Oh, wow. And we drop down to 5 frames a second again. For a second. Now it's back. The art of an internationally acclaimed painter, Richard Tarkovsky. Will you Google that for me? I wonder if that's a real
Rich
guy.
Tarkovsky, let's see here.
Tarkovsky. For the first time in the Neva Resort, June 14th through July 30th, 1982, the year I was born. And we dropped back down again. Oh, little footprints. Wait, so I can't go down there.
No, nothing came up.
I guess it's a fake person. Okay, so I'm going to try to leave my body again and go upstairs. Oh, no, I can't because there's no... Duh. see if frame rates tank again. I'm going to try to fill up my spirit energy again. Okay, well that's weird. The frame rates didn't tank this time. I'd have to try to dig deeper to see if, see what's going on here. I mean, the GPU is getting fully utilized, CPU not so much, so I'd... Okay, I guess I can't go anywhere else here. Because I can't go up. I just can't do it. I will say this little piano melody is total Akira Yamaoka. Like, yeah, some of it I can't necessarily tell between which composer is doing it, but this is totally his style.
Biggest fan is no other than Adam Patrick Murray.
Okay. Now where did she go?
Oh boy. We tanked there again for a second. I wonder if it's like a loading in kind of thing. Like it's... Can't interact with the door. Oh look, there's little footprints again. Oh, okay.
Huh. What is that?
This looks pretty cool.
Okay, not getting through here.
That looks like a creepy-ass Geiger, H.R. Geiger door handle. I ain't touching that thing.
I didn't even know I could do that.
Engaged spirit shield. Okay. So Hayden Lambert, I am using the most recent game ready driver that was released. What was it, today or yesterday? So I have the newest NVIDIA driver. Yes. But I do not have the newest version of the game. I am playing the pre-release. Review copy of the game. Oh, there's a key. Oh, and once again the frame rate tanked, and now it's back. Oh, and look at those textures. Yeah, huh.
Oh, wow. Trippy.
Weird. Yeah, look at that key. No, thank you. Further down the hall, but wait, let me go back to that room. Oh, that doesn't sound good. Oh, I can't go any further back. Hey, there we go.
Yes. I'm working on it. Yes, I know. I just... Yes. I understand. Just give me some time. A few days. You'll get what you want.
Ugh. That voice. I don't know why, but it gives me shivers.
Matthew Lambert, or I'm sorry, not Matthew Lang, Hayden Lambert. Hayden, I was provided pre-release code from NVIDIA. I'm part of certain review guide lists.
Looks like the only way.
I'm not reviewing this game for PC World, but I do get pre-release codes to be able to stream them on PC World, so that is how I got this code.
This room, it feels cold. Memories of grief, loneliness. The spark's too weak to absorb. It's like it's missing something. Some objects soak up moments from the past. Just squeeze in the right spot and let it pour out.
Well, that's an interesting mechanic. So I'm rotating the left thumbstick and finding the spot where it meets. Hold it there for a moment.
Ah, sunflower, weary of time. For my favorite nurse.
Oh, Mr. Tarkovsky, you shouldn't have.
Please, it's the least I can do for all the good work you do around here.
Huh. An actual happy memory. So there's more to this place than just doom and gloom.
Oh, I can interact with it. Let's see. Huh, that's an interesting...
Ah, sunflower, weary of time.
Oh, me...
An old prescription. I know these drugs all too well.
Ursula Rostowski? Rostowski? Treated with electroshock. 1930. Oh man, we're seeing that flicker again. Oh yeah, I fell through to a different floor. I totally forgot. I'm not on the second floor anymore. I'm back on the first floor. Oh, goodness. RT. Oh boy.
Idiot. Useless old hag. Why would he care any more than the others?
It's more than grief. More than despair. This letter crushed her spirit. Shit, there are thousands of them. I'm gonna need more energy to get through.
Uh-huh. Sad nurse. Yeah, makes me think once again of Silent Hill, the nurses. And oh, you never got to, did you get to see the nurses? No, I don't.
Which
think
on
did.
Which one?
Either of them.
Either of them, no. None.
Yeah, I realized after the time we streamed Silent Hill 2, I totally, we logged out before you even got to see the Hell World. Because the one of the things that they're cribbing from here is the fact that there's two worlds. In the Silent Hill games, there's usually multiple worlds as well, but you go into them, you're in them one at a time, and it's usually predetermined. So even though we played a couple hours of it...
Shoot. This is falling apart. Looks like I'm in for another dive.
Even though we played a couple hours of it, we didn't even get to the Hell World.
Is that skin?
Uh-huh. Yikes.
Oh, God. I hate this.
So yeah, now in this game, you're actually able to see both worlds at the same time. It's actually kind of a pretty cool concept. Oh, what's this? It's like another one of those memory things where I feel like I'm doing something wrong. Ah, oh.
What? What?
It's just a weird thing like floated by from the memory thing, but huh, okay. Well. Oh, there's the skin. Oh no, I'm running out of energy. Oh no. Crap. There's nothing in here. Oh, I'm looking through a peephole.
Oh my god. Oh my god.
Unfortunately, the frame rate dipped there, so it wasn't like you couldn't tell exactly what it was, but.
Still, with the sound effect.
Yeah.
All right. That's it, Adam. You're on your own. Bye. Gosh.
Yeah, just drain this tub filled with... who knows what it is. Oh, that's a razor blade. Oh,
this
boy.
This isn't a razor, it's... guilt. Shame. Regret.
Yikes. Can I put the razor blade in this thing? I think I need to put the... Oh, okay. With the razor blade, I can cut the skin. Okay, I got it.
If only I had something sharp.
Oh, man, this keeps tanking it.
Yeah. That one's disturbingly satisfying.
Yes. Yes, it was. Okay, let's go back to that pot. Oh, there's the sunflower. Okay, so now I can
this
take the sunflower.
Useful.
There we go.
The light of a memory strong enough to defy this place.
Okay. So now I can go back to that other room. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. What was written on that wall? Did you see that? Oh, no, it's... Oh, yeah. It says... What does that say? To hell if you are in here, that means I'm out there. So we're not gonna go out there.
There. Now it's strong enough.
Yeah, I think it's supposed to indicate how much spirit energy she has by her arm. Okay, wait, what was I supposed to do with all the energy? Oh, I need to use the shield thing. Okay, here we go. That is a cool camera angle. Yeah. Perhaps asking a good question, if I'm getting this kind of performance, why would I not play it with different settings? Number one, I'll say, I am maxing out everything here on stream just to kind of scientifically show what's going on here, because I feel like people are going to make their own informed decisions, of what's going on. So I like to be the guinea pig to say, hey, this is my rig, which is a pretty nice rig, and how it performs on here with everything, maxed out and trying to really push stuff. Number two, once again, this is a pre-release version of the game. This is not the final version of the game, so performance might be different in your case. Number three, yes, I would have different settings if I was just playing this not streaming, but I still love ray tracing and I still love the benefit it has visually, so I would take the time to sit down and kind of move through the settings and kind of see what works for me in my playstyle. So hopefully, once again, when I get the final version out there tomorrow, performance will be a little bit different. But I can't speak to that right now, obviously. So I'm just showing you what I have. Good question, though. Good question. Petro de la Nepalechik. Under it says no smoking floor, so I'm wondering if that's like a direct translation. Also, we are seeing that skin that it looks like I have to cut through again. Out of body time.
Sadness?
I feel like I have to come here to a little bit later or something. Oh, this is where I originally went in, isn't it? Oh, no, it's not. There's a hole. Oh yeah, because the flowers down there, I think. Oh, is there something in the sink? No. Oh, yeah, okay, this is where I jump down. This is where I listen to the echo. Okay. So, I'm just gonna go cut the skin. Hey, Dave Richards, what's going on? What, how old am I? 38? Something like that? 38, male. English. Sam, I So when you say nothing to do with Silent Hill, I'm going to have to disagree with you, because not only is it inspired by Silent Hill, the co-composer is from the Silent Hill series. So I would say, yes, it has something to do with Silent Hill. How much of it is up for debate, but it, yes, it does have something to do with Silent Hill. And Ryan, yes, this game is actually running on a SK Hynix Gold P31 NVMe SSD. Thank you for sponsoring the episode.
This thing looks strong.
Oh man, I hate how that skin just like wiggles. Oof.
Hate it or is satisfying?
Good question. Wait, so I need to get through here, but I don't think I have enough shield energy. I don't know what happens when my shield energy runs up. Run.
Oh boy.
Run. There we go. Okay. Oh boy. Just barely made it through. What's this? Old man. That old man does not look happy. And that looks like a bug. Oh no, that's a little girl because she has the butterfly in her dress. Yeah. Oh wait, what's...
Old invoices, outdated documents. Wonder why someone put them out here. Manager, huh?
Marianne!
Oh, sadness. We gotta stop meeting like this.
I told you to follow me!
Take it easy, Sad. This place is huge. It's easy to get lost.
Just stick with me.
Okay. I'll stick like a tick.
You're funny.
This Thomas Rekovich. All right. Listen, hon. You said you remembered someone named Thomas. Was it Thomas Rekovich? Was he the manager here?
I guess.
You think he stuck around?
I'm not sure. There was an old man here. Very recently. I think. Oh.
And you think it was Thomas?
Oh, I don't know. Old men all look the same, all wrinkly and old. Blah.
Hey.
Dang it, she's talking about me.
Very nice. Well, if he's still around, I've got an infestation to report.
Marianne! I feel... Oh, I don't think we should be here.
It's okay, Sadness. Look, there's no one... here. Sadness?
She's like, I'm gonna peace out. Sabori Zero, good question. I've read reports, probably... one review said to six to eight hours. Another review I saw said 10. So it's on the shorter side, which actually for a horror game like this, that's like perfect. And the music is, oh boy, And then somebody asked, is the frame time stutter noticeable, Ryan asked that. As of right now, yes. Like, if I'm sitting right here, you can see those little frame time spikes. It's not really that noticeable here, but, I mean, we're getting, you know, major performance hitches depending on where I'm at and what I'm doing.
It all hit me as soon as I entered the room.
And that is definitely noticeable.
Anguish. Fear. Longing. There's a Biscup, Bailey Biscup cigarettes over there.
Bailey?
I think so. I couldn't tell. It looked like the a different kind of symbol.
I could instantly tell there was more to that clock than met the eye. Locked.
Locked.
Grand opening, I assume. Hey, is that the first secretary? They must have had some big plans for this place.
Oh. I see.
figures. There's gotta be a way to power it up.
Oh, there's a map. Good old map.
Huh, the signature. So he designed this whole place? Who are you, Thomas Rekovich? Hell happened here. My senses jolted as I touched the phone. I could tell it had been used recently to call me. Burn marks, broken glass, and is that salt? Someone jotted this down recently.
Don't turn off that alarm clock at 3 o'clock.
Yeah. Check up on L. I don't know who L is.
Huh. Still works.
Hey, flashlight.
Someone's been using it.
Huh. And a key.
Too small to fit a door.
But maybe a clock. Oh, look, I've got my the lights on. You see that? It's casting just a little bit of a... Oh, yeah, there we go. Oh, he's so... Yeah, that's how they used to wear lights in Silent Hill. That's funny.
There we go.
Oh, so I need to set the time. Wait, what was the... What did the thing say? Oh, well, I guess it doesn't matter.
That's as far as it goes. There. The imprint.
Oh.
Is that... Thomas? As I moved the clock hand, I realized it was a junction between realities. It's rare, but I'd seen it before.
No. Don't do it. I can't. We must. Wait. I can feel something's wrong. It's coming.
Warrior Zero had that flashlight too. Nice.
There! Looks like a passage.
This time, it's taking too long. What am I missing?
Can't tell what the hell is talking about.
A spirit well. I could absorb some of that energy.
Well. Judging by her arm, it looks like just one pole fills it up. Okay, that's good.
I'm so lost without you. I don't know if I can do this, but... enough. Get it together.
Looks like I'm in for another dive.
Oh, gotta check the wire. I'd hate to get stuck in there.
Someone tried real hard to keep this place a secret. Wonder what's in here on the other side. Let's see if it worked.
So the reviewer's guide actually did say that this is this art is based off of an artist. Now that I'm remembering, I keep thinking Geiger, but it's not Geiger. Let me find the artist's name, just so I can do him service. Here we go. Oh boy. Oh no. ZDZISLAW. Zidzislaw. Oh, sorry, I'm butchering that. B-E-K-S-I-N-S-K-I. Beck Sinsky. Zidzislaw Beck-Sinsky. I did look up a little bit of his... oh, no. Whoops, I should have paused as I did that. Yeah, I did look up a little bit of his artwork, but yeah, this game's... They took inspiration from his art. Oh no. I should have paused it while I was reading that. Whoops. And well, now I know what happens when you die, quote unquote, in the out of body experience. Oh no, I have to do all this again. Okay. I read that. I think I looked at this. Yeah.
That seems pretty far back.
It all hit me as soon as I entered the room.
That's a bummer.
Anguish. Fear. Longing. I could instantly tell there was more to that clock than met the eye.
So even though I don't need to, I do like to retrace my steps just so I did the same exact thing for this, for the runs. I don't know why.
Grand opening, I assume. Hey, is that the first secretary? They must... figures.
Okay. Then I think I looked at the map over here. Then I looked at its name.
This is Signet.
Yep. And then... I went to the desk.
What the hell happened here?
My senses jolted as I touched the phone. I could tell to call Burnmark. Someone jotted this down recently. It still works. Too small.
Okay. Sorry, folks, I know you just saw it, but I want to do these things again.
There we go. There. An imprint. As I moved the clock hand, I realized it was a junction between realities. It's rare, but I'd seen it before.
No. Don't do it. I can't. We must. Wait. I can feel something's wrong. It's coming.
There. Looks like a passage.
Shit. I thought I had it this time. It's taking too long. What am I missing?
A spirit well.
I'm so lost without you. I don't know if I can do this, but enough. Get it together.
Looks like I'm in for another dive.
Oh, gotta check the wiring. I'd hate to get stuck in there.
Someone tried real hard to keep this place a secret. Wonder what's in here on the other side. Let's see if it worked.
It's like this, like, little scorched earth area. Okay, so I guess I can go here. Now I can hit this button.
Okay.
There we go.
Let's get the rest of me in there.
Nice.
I'll never get used to this. Ugh.
Hey, Moira.
I hate to think what kind of photos need this much secrecy.
More photo development. Developer, stop, fixer. Don't forget about the red light. Light 5 second time in each tray 3 second.
Okay, I know how this works. I need 3 liquids to develop the photo.
Oh, I don't have the liquids. Oh. Hey, okay.
Looks like there's a tray missing.
Looks like I gotta get some materials. Okay.
Nope. Doesn't work.
Ah. Actually, that's probably what I do with the photo after I develop it. Oh, there's the fixer.
That's one. 2 more to go.
Third time's the charm. Maybe that's a photography joke. Oh, there's the stop. So you want to be a photographer.
So you want to be a photographer.
It's true. I want to be a photographer. Suppressing the supernatural.
Huh? Hmm. Not sure I like the sound of that. I could sense something stirring behind that symbol, like a gust of wind moving a curtain.
getting stronger. I wonder what it's talking about.
Hope he's not using it as a textbook.
I forgot to check the other objects. See if there was... Hammer of Witches. Nope, there it is. Multigrade.
Okay.
Your first step
That's
to photo development. Oh wait, I need a tray though. Oh, there it is.
This should come in handy.
Got it. Okay, let's put the tray down. Let's... Oh, wait. So it's developer, stop, fixer. Developer. Or I guess multigrade? Stop. Fixer. Okay. Alright, you ready, Willis?
Alright,
let's see if we do this. Alright, so 1001, 1002, 1003, 1004, 1005. Paper, and it's developer stop fixer. Okay. 1001, 1002, 1003. There we go. Man, we're professional photographers, Willis. Oh,
it's
her.
You didn't even need to try it.
What the hell?
Oh, spooky.
Who's there?
Are you all right?
Don't. Look at me!
I tried to run the wrong way. Whoops. Also, I will say that's prime Akira Yamaoka music right here.
Oh, God.
Don't leave me here.
Run, Adam.
Alone. Naked. Let me try you on.
Oh, God. No.
Don't worry.
No.
Won't be home ever again. Everything. It all ends in me.
Not a fan of light, huh? Fucking figures.
Okay, I'm good. I'm good. Okay.
Oh,
oh boy. Great question.
Most people spend their whole lives seeing only a fraction of our reality. Lucky them. I have spent my whole life looking beyond the edges of our reality. Even as a child, I saw things that would break a grown man. Eventually, I grew into it. It became my normal. But that thing, it was anything but normal. I've never encountered anything like this. This ravenous. I felt lost.
I came to Neva looking for answers, and all I got was more questions. What was that monster? Who was Thomas? And what did he want from me?
So she's being interviewed by somebody. Obviously after the fact. That's interesting.
Marianne! Wake up, please! Marianne!
I woke up with icy water in my veins. I wanted nothing but to get out of there. To just get up and run until my legs give out, until my lungs collapse. But I knew I couldn't. It wouldn't have solved anything. And besides, Sadness needed my help.
So I think this is probably a good place to stop. Yes, it did save. Oh boy. Okay. Well, first reactions, so far I'm bummed by the technical things going on, but I will, like I said before, I am going to wait till the day when I get the day one version. I will mess around a little bit more with how things are configured and whatnot, but I mean, honestly, I'm loving it. The technical stuff it's a bummer. It's getting in the way because this is totally up my alley, especially the music, the mood, the cinematic camera angles. I'm not gonna say it's perfect. You know, we'll see where it lands in my favorite, Silent Hill kind of wrestling with horror games. But I don't know. I'm digging it. I'm digging it. I want to go some more. Willis, what do you think? What are your thoughts so far?
So far it looks good. I mean, this kind of the gameplay style reminds me a little bit of, was it from the developers from Beyond Two Souls? It was a Quantic Dream, fixed angles, mm-hmm. and just the interactive gameplay. And yeah, I mean, this is pretty good. It's, I think someone on the chat says, is this a horror game? Because for me right now, it is a horror, but it's more like into a thriller than it is horror. At the same time, I don't know. How do you characterize this?
Horror and thriller is definitely an age-old debate on what belongs what where. I don't see thriller as like a spectrum between horror, like, you know, you go one to the other. I think they're two separate things. Usually I think thriller like involves more grounded in reality kind of content, where horror, okay, in my definition, is usually something that's outside of the realm of just pure reality. Whether it's gory or supernatural or something kind of over the top, those lines definitely get blurred between thriller. But for me, at least my definition of it, thriller usually isn't supernatural. It's usually more of the crime, okay, or, you know, things like that.
Right.
Yeah, that's my definition, though. I mean, I'm not the expert here. I would consider this horror. I think this is actually, even though I've only beat one of Bloober Team's games, I've dabbled in a couple other ones, but this definitely feels like a marriage between Bloober Team's previous stuff and Silent Hill. This is definitely not a Silent Hill game, but it's got enough DNA there. But it also is coming at it from the modern trappings of a Bloober Team thing. I will say, keep in mind, this is a smaller team. This is not Konami. This is not a developer throwing a ton of money. This is not meant to be a AAA game. I think a lot of people are propping this up as a AAA game because it is it's like one of the only Xbox series or Xbox exclusives right now. So a lot of people are kind of looking at it. There's a lot of marketing around it. It's definitely being promoted a lot, but it's not, in my mind, a AAA game. And so, like, I'm quicker to excuse some of the stuff, the little rougher edges. Hopefully the performance stuff will get ironed out. It's cool they implemented ray tracing stuff, you know, because I definitely appreciate, you know, pushing the boundary on that, and it looks pretty when it works. But yeah, for me, especially knowing their past games, this feels like kind of one of their most ambitious games that they've done. So I think that's probably why they're, you know, some things struggle a little bit. I kind of knew going in that that's kind of where I should keep my expectations, because it's always about expectation management. But I will say, in terms of expectation management, my expectations could not be higher for the soundtrack. And so far, watch this. Mwah. Yes. This is my jam. Love it. I love it. Yeah. Anyway, Observer, that was the other big Bloober Team game. Yes. My definition of AAA is something that has hundreds of people on the team, like millions of dollars thrown at it. I don't believe this team is that big. I don't believe they threw that much money at this game. I think this is just being kind of pushed and marketed as a AAA kind of experience. That's how I'm reading it. Could be a potential, but also, I mean, you're kind of limited. Horror games, I think, are, by definition of it being a horror game, is going to be limited to a certain audience. A lot of people don't like playing horror. I love it, but I totally understand that it's a smaller market segment. So, of course, they're not going to throw a ton of money and resources behind something that's going to be kind of niche to begin with, if that makes sense. Anyway, I don't know. I'm torn on whether I want to stream more of it, mostly for personal reasons. Number one, I want to play more of this tonight, which means that if I were to stream it, I would love to be able to just stream it back to back to back, and be able to do a complete playthrough. But at the same time, I want to continue playing this tonight. So. I'm kind of torn. I don't know if there's enough support that people are going to yell and be like, hey, you should stream it regardless of it being continuity. I do want to enjoy it on my own terms, though. It's definitely personally a different experience streaming games than just straight playing games by myself. So and yes, you know what, Chris Martel, good point. Small team marketed as literally the next thing, you know, the next huge thing. That's a good way to put it. Yeah, marketing is definitely hyping this up, and it should be. It is. So far, I'm digging the game, but I don't think it's going to be for everybody. I think it's going to get a lot of hate. That's cool. If it's coming to Xbox Game Pass and you have Game Pass, try it out, right? And that's cool that you're interested in it, Willis. That's the other thing. I wouldn't want to stream more of it with you if you're gonna try to play it on your own too, because I think it's definitely
it's more fun watching you play it.
Let's see. Stream. Please stream it without RTX. I don't know. I'll think about it. Hit me up on Discord, Twitter, whatever. Either way, there is another game coming out tomorrow that I was thinking about maybe streaming, and it's for series of games, I guess. For the first time on PC, there's gonna be the Yakuza Remastered Collection comes out. So it's Yakuza 3, 4, and 5, I think, are coming for the very first time outside of a Sony console. Which is cool. I mean, it's not necessarily where you want to start the journey, but I've always been curious in the Yakuza games, and I guess the sixth one is then gonna come out in like March or something like that. So the sixth one's gonna be a little late, but I was thinking about maybe streaming that. And I don't know. I mean, I'm gonna play more of this. yeah. Anyway, obviously, if you stream too much of it, it won't be worth buying for us. Hey, well, it's on Game Pass. You should probably have Game Pass already because it's awesome. Yeah. Anyway, thank you for joining, everybody. I'm gonna go absorb this. I'm gonna absorb this in my skin. I'm gonna lather myself, rinse, you know, and enjoy the the soundtrack as much as I can. Thank you, Willis, for watching, and joining me, holding my hand virtually.
thanks everyone for joining and holding our hands.
I know, right? Thank you everybody in the chat, hanging out, talking about the game, talking about Silent Hill, talking about all this fun stuff. I love video games. Video games are fun, and I'm having a damn good time with this one. Also, thank you to SK Hynix for sponsoring the stream, providing the drive for this build. Stay tuned in our Discord. That's where you'll kind of know when upcoming streams happen and whatnot. So if I decide to stream this game tomorrow, or maybe Yakuza or something, that's where you'll probably hear from it. So anyway, thanks again, everybody, and we will see you later. Until then, I'm gonna get out of here. I'm gonna go. I need to absorb. Anyway, bye, everybody.
See ya.